This is the training for level 2 in the North Carolina Department of Transportation Erosion and Sediment Control Certification Program. The purpose of the training is to prepare attendees for the exam, which is given in order to qualify for the certification. First, we're going to talk about the certification, and then we'll talk about the test. There are three levels in the certification program. Level 1 certification is for people who are directly involved in the installation and maintenance of best management practices on NCDOT construction sites. Level 2, this training, is for those who oversee all or major portions of the erosion and sediment control on projects. Level 3 certification is for those people who actually prepare the design plans for erosion and sediment control. Usually these are engineers and landscape architects. There's more information and details about each of these levels and their responsibilities in the front part of the handout, which is contained for all these presentations. We will not go through a lot of these details. There are two types of level 2 people who may be on a project. First, a supervisor manages all aspects of erosion and sediment control on a project. They have to understand all the practices, ensure the erosion and sediment control plans are being implemented, and manage any activities related to erosion and sediment control. In addition, a level 2 supervisor maintains quality control on all the practices, such as maintenance needs, and keeps inspection records on all of the practices. We'll discuss inspections in detail in more detail later. For larger projects, there may be up to 3 level 2 foremen. These oversee erosion sediment control for one or more of these 3 activities: grading, bridge and culvert work over jurisdictional waters, and utilities. Here are some frequently asked questions. First, can a level 2 foreman substitute for a level 1 person? Yes, they can, but in that case, someone has to take the level 2 foreman position. In other words, no one can wear 2 certification hats on a construction project. Also, are certified people required on all NCDOT projects? The answer is yes, if there is an erosion and sediment control plan. There is another private certification program which offers 2 levels of certification. These are either acceptable as a substitute for both levels or just level 1. The goal of the certification program is to be sure there are knowledgeable staff on every project to ensure erosion and sediment control is taken care of. If problems arise, such as the following types of violations, which we'll discuss later, it is possible that the person responsible will lose their certification. Note that this is not certain, but it is up to NCDOT staff to determine whether there will be a revocation or suspension. So, if someone has their certification revoked, it will be for 1 year. In that case, someone else will have to fill their role on the project, which could be a major hardship finding another individual who is certified. Once a year has passed, certification can be regained by passing the test again. Now about the test. It is 50 questions. 35 of these have to be answered correctly in order to be certified. In other words, you have to score a 70 or better on the test. It's open book, so you can use any handout, book, or other reference material at your disposal. You cannot receive help from other individuals, however. The certification lasts for 3 years from the date of your test. In these examples, you can see that you are given whatever is left of the year where you take the test, and then it's 3 years after that. After that period of time, 3 years plus the remainder of the existing year, you will need to be recertified by taking another test. All certified individuals get their name placed on a list which is maintained on the web, as you can see here. This helps everyone keep track of their certification and may help potential employers verify the certification. This completes this module on the NCDOT Erosion Sediment Control Certification Program.